Certain species defy assumptions and traverse the plains of Africa. African wild dogs are not only hunters, they also have distinctive coats and intricate social networks. They serve as a reminder of how magnificent nature is. We're going to explore the fascinating world of the African wild dog, so be ready to be impressed, see their magnificent hunts, investigate their complex social structures, and learn why these amazing animals are struggling to survive. Meet one of the most amazing hunters in Africa, African wild dog. These intriguing animals are African wild dogs, often called painted dogs or cape hunting dogs. These are sub-Saharan African predators that are gregarious by nature. Wolves and jackals might be thought of as near cousins of the African wild dog, as it belongs to the canine family. Following the gray wolf in size, the African wild dog is the second biggest dog when it comes to withers, reaching a weight of 40 kilograms and an 80 centimeters height. With their asymmetrical patches of black, brown, yellow, and white on their coats, African wild dogs have a distinctive and captivating look. They fit in with their surroundings more naturally because of their camouflage design. These canines are very nimble because of their lengthy legs and sleek bodies. In order to surround and pursue victims, pack members cooperate with one another. They are faster than most other hunters, with the ability to sustain a pace of up to 70 kilometers per hour. Being able to pull down victims that are much bigger than they are is made possible by their strong jaws and pointed teeth, which are designed to rip through flesh. With up to 40 members in their packs, African wild dogs are extremely gregarious animals. Associated females, their young, and the dominant breeding couple make up these packs. They use a variety of hunting techniques. They could even utilize a blocking approach, in which some dogs block paths for escape while others chase the victim, or a relay system, in which new predators take the place of exhausted ones. Members of the pack divide duties, with each member taking shifts protecting the area, hunting, and tending to the pups. A couple, related females, and their young ones. The extraordinary hunting abilities of African wild dogs are well known. Using their endurance and cooperation, they can pursue victims across great distances. African wild dogs are expert predators of medium-sized antelopes, but they can also take down impalas, juvenile wildebeests, and warthogs. African wild dogs have a reputation for having a high success rate. The dominance order among wild dogs is evident, as it is in many other sociable creatures. The alpha couple is in charge of the group, reproducing and making important choices. Puppies' upbringing is a shared duty among pack individuals. This involves giving them food, keeping them safe, and imparting vital survival knowledge. It is well known that these canines have an intricate system of interaction and are adept at addressing issues. Among the pack, these canines interact by a range of vocalizations, body language, and markings of scent. The remarkable hunting success rate of African wild dogs is well known. It frequently approaches 80%. Their remarkable collaboration and perseverance are demonstrated by this. African wild dogs are monogamous to the exclusion of several other dog species. Since they are the sole reproducing couple in the pack, the alpha male and female develop a close attachment. Reproduction usually takes place at a certain season, however, there is significant variance across populations. As an illustration, the reproductive season in southern Africa normally runs from April to July. A female's estrus can extend for up to 20 days. In order to keep her from mating with other men, the alpha male constantly watches her throughout this period. Despite the protracted mating observed in many other dogs, the actual breeding process is swift. More than any other canid, African wild dogs typically produce litters of 10 puppies. However, they can have as few as 6 or as many as 16. In a den, typically an abandoned aardvark burrow, the dominant mother gives birth to her offspring. As puppies, they are born blind and defenseless. Nurturing the puppies is a major responsibility for the whole pack. Other pack members provide meals, guard the territory, and assist in caring for the pups while the alpha female tends to their basic needs. Regretfully, a large percentage of puppies die. Numerous others die from illnesses, malnutrition, or predators. The females of African wild dogs depart from their natal group, in contrast to many other animals where the males usually scatter. Inbreeding is lessened by this dispersion. Females that disperse might join already existing packs or start new ones. This dynamic social framework plays a role in maintaining the population's general genetic well-being. To find a possible victim, wild dogs must have excellent vision. When a prey is located, the pack moves slowly towards it, frequently hiding their motions behind cover. The pack charges at its full pace after the victim, striking at the appropriate instant to attack. The canines gradually wear out their victim by persistent chase and cooperation, getting the opportunity for a last assault. The alpha pair and the pups are usually given priority, although the whole pack enjoys the food following an effective hunt. African wild dogs use their ability to regurgitate flesh to specifically nourish their ill or wounded pack members. African wild dogs use their keen sense of vision and hearing mostly in daytime hunting. However, in the broad savanna, scent is not as important for hunting. About 2 kilograms of flesh are typically consumed daily by each African wild dog. The African wild dog, however, has been known to consume up to 8 kilograms of flesh at once in specific circumstances. African wild dogs nearly seldom consume carcasses. Instead, they prey alone or steal fresh meat from other hunters, such as leopards. The comparatively small teeth of African wild dogs are excellent for aggressively repressing victims. However, they also prevent a swift death by a deep cut to the important organs. Even lions are unable to defeat an adult African buffalo, which may weigh up to a ton. It is difficult to take down an adult buffalo, not even by a very big pack of African wild dogs. However, young buffalo or calf are excellent candidates for victimization. African wild dogs can frequently gather a whole herd of buffaloes with relative ease. The tiniest and most vulnerable buffalo are separated from the herd by African wild dogs. Furthermore, African wild dogs continue to have the upper hand because of their large numbers, pace, and agility, even if some herd members continue to defend the newborn. The wildebeest is another huge mammal that African wild dogs frequently feed on. African wild canines have the ability to consume even the largest of wildebeests, who may weigh up to 300 kilograms. They pick the most vulnerable and slowest member, wear it out with a protracted runaway, and then immobilize and destroy it. Big herbivores' extraordinary bravery in defending their herd forces African wild dogs to hunt for simpler victims. Even when surrounded by a big pack, African wild dogs will not assault some relatively tiny creatures. Baboons are one of these. They reside in big, tight groups and are rather violent animals with strong teeth, much like African wild dogs. Both the honey badger and African wild dogs seek to avoid combat, with the latter often displaying little concern in the former. African wild dogs find it rather challenging to kill honey badgers, and they have less flesh. Spotted hyenas and lions are the primary rivals and adversaries of African wild dogs. African wild dogs are frequently caught and killed by lions, which do this not for sustenance, but rather to drive out rivals along with routinely robbing them of their victim. Juvenile lions and cubs are frequently preyed upon by African wild dogs. Even mature lions that have been debilitated by illness or wounds have been killed by African wild dogs on many occasions. As with African wild dogs, spotted hyenas are gregarious animals that hunt in packs, but they are more powerful than these dogs, with an adult weighing up to 90 kilograms. Occasionally, African wild dogs and spotted hyena confrontations result in fatalities. The native environment of wild dogs is disappearing due to population growth and cultivation of land for growing crops and other purposes. They are seriously threatened by confrontations with people, especially reprisal kills. Rabies and dog distemper outbreaks have the potential to completely destroy packs, particularly in regions where the number of domestic dogs and humans is large. Illicit trading in wild dog body components does happen, albeit not as often as it happens for different kinds of dogs. Through community engagement, avoidance of illness, and anti-poaching activities, several organizations are trying to safeguard these majestic animals and their ecosystems. To save these amazing creatures, preservation measures are essential. We can endeavor to protect them for next generations by learning about their habits and difficulties. Please subscribe to the channel and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. That's everything for today. Have a good one, and bye.